गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज डॉक्टर प्रशांत पाटिल, टीकेआईटी वारणानगर, मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट.
दिस इज डॉक्टर एन एस दाराशंकर, टाटा सेट फॉर इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी, वारणानगर.
ओके, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द एक्सपेरिमेंट बाय फिलर सस्पेंशन. जनरली फॉर रेगुलर शेप्ड ऑब्जेक्ट्स सच एज रेक्टेंगुलर बार, सर्कुलर डिस्क और ट्रैंगुलर शेप्ड ऑब्जेक्ट्स, theoretical formulas are available to determine the center of gravity, also radius of gyration and mass moment of inertia. But for irregular shaped bodies such as connecting rod or irregular shaped stones, there is no theoretical formulas are available to determine the radius of gyration, then center of gravity, also mass moment of inertia. So experimental methods has been derived to determine the mass moment of inertia, radius of gyration of irregular shaped objects. So before actual applying that experimental method to irregular shaped objects, first we verify the validity of that method by using bipillar and tripillar suspension. So first today we are going to discuss bipillar suspension. Bipillar suspension means the object is suspended with the help of two strings, and for this object, for this experiment, the object is rectangular shaped bars. So here this is the experimental setup. This is rectangular shaped bar. This bar's dimensions such as length of the bar 0.500 meter is given in the manual. Also the mass of the bar is given in the manual. It is 0.064 kg. Now this bar is suspended with the help of two strings, vertically suspended with the help of two strings. Now the length of the suspension, that is capital L, is measured with the help of tape, measuring tape, or with the help of scale. So here I am measure the length of the suspension, that is capital L, that is 0.230 meter. So this length of the suspension is 0.23 meter. Now in manual, length of the bar is given, also the mass of this bar is given. Also during observation, before starting the experiment, you have to measure the distance between CG of this bar and point of suspension with the help of this scale. So it is 0.30 meter. So mass of the bar and length of the bar is given in the manual. Before starting the experiment, you have to measure length of the suspension, that is capital L, and distance between center of this CG of this bar and point of suspension, that is E. This is measured. Now after recording this initial observation, now we are going to perform the experiment. So during experiment, you disturb this rectangular bar by applying hand force. So I disturb this bar. Now this bar start oscillating. So with the help of stopwatch, you measure the time required for n number of oscillations. So first we measure the time required for 10 oscillations. In next observation, again we disturb this bar and measure the time required for 10 oscillations. Now this time required for n oscillations is recorded in the observation table, and further calculations have been carried out. So next observation part, observation table and calculation part is explained by my colleague Dr. N. S. Dharashukar. Please sir.
Calculation part of this bipillar suspension system. The aim of the experiment is to measure the moment of inertia of the bodies having irregular shape. But here we are going to verify the actual and theoretical results. So we have considered an even shaped body, it is nothing but a rectangular bar. As it is discussed by Dr. P.J. Patil sir, these are the observations. First, mass of the bar, it is 0.064 kg. Next, distance of suspended point from the CG, it is nothing but A. As it is discussed by Dr. P.J. Patterson, it is bipolar suspension system. So this rectangular bar is suspended at two points. So distance of suspended point from the CG, it is 230 millimeter, or it is 0.230 meter. Then length of the bar, small a, it is 0.500 meter or 500 millimeter. Let us discuss the observation table. So this is length of suspension L in meter. It is 510 millimeter. It is kept constant for all the observations. It is 0.510 meter or 510 millimeter. As it is discussed, distance of suspension point from CG, that is A, it is 0.234 meter. 0.230 meter. Then we have given oscillations, that is 10 oscillations, 15 oscillations and 20 oscillations. And consequently, we have measured the time for n oscillations. That is the time for 10 oscillations, 15 oscillations and 20 oscillations. So here in this case, the time for 10 oscillations, the time for 10 oscillations, it is 8.20 seconds. Next, time for 15 oscillation, it is 13.29 seconds. And time for 20 oscillations, that is 17.92 seconds. Now, periodic time is the capital T. It is nothing but the time required for n oscillations. As an example, what is the periodic time for n oscillations? It is 10.20 divided by 10. It is 0.82 seconds per cycle. The periodic time T is nothing but capital T divided by N. For first observation, it is 0.82 seconds per cycle. For second observation, it is 0.886 seconds per cycle. And for third case, it is 0.896 seconds per cycle. This is the mean time, that is mean of all these three observations has been taken, and it is 0.883 seconds per cycle. That is the mean T experimental. That is the mean theoretical mean periodic time. Let us switch to the calculations. So this formula has been derived. It is K experimental, it is nothing but T experimental divided by 2 pi under root G A square divided by N. Let us repeat it again. K experimental, it is equal to T experimental divided by 2 pi under root G A square divided by N. Then K experimental, it is nothing but the radius of gyration of that body. T experimental, it is nothing but the periodic time. G is the acceleration due to gravity. A is nothing but distance of suspended point from the center of gravity. And L is nothing but the distance of the suspension point from the L is nothing but the distance of the suspended point from the reference. Distance of the suspended point from the reference, it is nothing but capital L. It is taken as 0.510 meter. This is 0.510 meter. So K, by substituting all these values, you are getting K experimental as 0.1417 meter. That is the radius of gyration, you are getting it as 0.1417 meter. Now this is the K theoretical. So you have found out, you know this formula. you have derived it from the applied mechanics. This is nothing but L divided by root 12. L is nothing but the length of the rectangular bar. It is 0.500 meter. So 0.500 divided by root 12, it is the k theoretical value. That is the theoretical radius of direction. It is coming as 0.1443 meter. Ultimately, I experimental, it is nothing but m into k experimental square. You know, the mass of the rectangular strip as 0.064 kg. Mass of the bar, rectangular bar, it is 0.064 kg. So it is 0.064 kg into k experimental, that is 0.1417 square. It is coming as 1.285 into 10⁻². This is the I experimental, and this is the value of the moment of inertia which has been found out experimentally. Now I theoretical, it is nothing but m into k theoretical square. You know, the mass of the rectangular bar, it is nothing but 0.064 kg. It is 0.064 kg into k theoretical, it is nothing but 0.1443 square. So it is coming as 1.33 into 10⁻²² kg meter square. So let us see the percentage deviation in the results. It is nothing but I theoretical minus I experimental divided by I theoretical. It is nothing but 1.285 into 10⁻². Minus 1.33 into 10⁻², divided by 1.33 into 10⁻². So percentage of deviation is found to be 3.7%. It is found to be 3.7. So it is below 10%. So the theoretical results and experimental results are showing very good agreement. In this way, our aim has been proved. Thank you very much.